Right. Exodus.
Freeze, Drifter! So, we meet again? Though I bet you don't remember who dragged you out of the water. My name is Olga, by the way. Was it you fighting the Master of the Forest? Awesome. Our hunters had been staying away from him for years. Damn it! Sorry, teacher. The locks all rusted up. Your friend Alyosha is already at the dam. He said your colonel won't wait, so you don't have much time. Sorry, I can't take you there. At today's council session, the pirates moved to attack your train, but they had no right to even call one without me present. As usual, I need to go and sort this out. But I have a few minutes to give you some directions. You need a boat to get to the dam, and our pirates keep all the boats at their swamp camp. They are not the sharing kind, but that's no reason to attack. Nobody wants bloodshed, so just stay out of their sight. Take the road to the barricade. Go down to the swamp and find the dock. That's where Alyosha and I took the boat from. Teacher, forgive me. There are some left, but be careful. Well, Drifter, take care. And don't make me sorry I helped you people. Tell Alyosha I said. I'll stay a bit longer to tend to the grave of the teacher.
Decided to relax a bit before the trip. That's a good idea.
And I'm stuck in fire. Once the master decided to haunt the
city, very good idea considering how long it took me to get past through that last section.
Those they haven't forgotten. The teacher raised us all, taught us how to survive in the forest. If not for him, we'd all be long dead. So the girls used to come here every day, and the boys still like it from time to time. Even Roman does visit, though it was because of him that the teacher left back then. Most of us went on a trip down the river. There were just a few people left on duty in the camp. When we came back, we found it raided by bandits. It still pains me to remember this. Can't even describe it. Once we and the younger group were done crying, the teacher was digging the graves. The elder boys were nowhere to be seen. We helped the teacher with burying ours. It was dark already when the boys returned and sat around the campfire. Roman was so covered with blood. You could only see his eyes and teeth. Then, they started talking. Tracking was easy. The bandits didn't even try covering their tracks. So the boys waited till they all got drunk in their camp and shot them with bows. Then Roman knifed the wounded like they would do. The teacher just sat there listening. I can still see his chin trembling. And he didn't say anything. Anything at all. They understood what he meant. Come morning, he was gone. To his church. At first, he wouldn't speak to anyone. But us girls kept checking up on him. Just to bring him some berries,
or ask for advice. And gradually, he started speaking to us. Still, he was like a different man, so distant. He never talked to the older voice anymore, though he'd reply to their letters. And to the rest of us who'd keep visiting him, he would always say we had to become their conscience, keep them from becoming monsters. But how did he do that? And they didn't stop at that either. Started calling themselves pirates, made the flooded lumber mill in the swamp their private HQ. Then they started hanging bandits from the posts, calling them masts. One day they took about 10 bandits alive and used them to test all the boats. Made them kill the bastards. None of ours could do it. And they all got called cowards for that. And then got ostracized. That's how the pioneers came to be. Of course, they all calmed down by now. They are talking to each other, at least. But back then, only Luda and I could speak for the teacher at the council meetings. In the end, Luda and a few boys just couldn't take it anymore and left. I wonder if they found a better place to live. I still keep checking the radio, hoping to hear from them. The teacher hoped too, but that hope didn't last long. They left in July, and in September, he shot himself. That seemed to get through to Roman. He got calmer. Some of the elder guys went over to the pioneers. After all, the important thing is that we stay together. So now I have an important voice at the council. Cause I can kick ass if they don't listen. And not just because they're not supposed to hurt girls. A fair fight is a fair fight. Thing is, the only one I lost to in a fair fight was Roman. And even then, I gave him a blue eye he had to wear for a week. That earned his respect. The one I had the most trouble with was the Edler. He was Roman's right hand man. Wouldn't leave the lumber mill no matter what. Kept saying we must defend it. If we don't want the mutants to eat the whole valley.
You talk too much.
But the radiation levels kept climbing there. Roman checked it with the counter himself. So at one council meeting, Roman and our instructors had everyone vote against the Admiral. And the pirates went on to build a new fort near the shore, where it's still okay to stay. The Admiral would have none of that. So he and his most hardcore flunkies stayed at the mill. I never heard from them again. Radiation's not to be played with. The teacher didn't burn us all for nothing. So now, without the Admiral, there is nobody to dare to give me any trouble. I'll put a leash on them. Don't you worry. I just need some time to get away. Thank you.
weren't taking that damage for nothing.
Thank you.
never stop. Here we go.
I'll get the bandit that killed your friend.
Thank you. to come out now, but if I don't find you, I don't know who's gonna find you sooner. The wolf or the master?
Well, I was given a save, that's good. I'll end the session here. I think it's been quite long enough for the time being. See you next time.